So, welcome back. It is I, Delmico L. Cunningham, better known as Dr. Media. So, this episode, I decided to look at a program that I've fallen out of love with it. Maya will always be there as my very first foray into the 3D, into the professional 3D world. Maya was kind of my, as they say, first love when it came to real professional 3D graphics. And since then, I have moved on to other programs. I'm a heavy user of Silo when it comes to just modeling. But, you know, I still tell people to pick what you enjoy. So if you enjoy working in Maya, work in Maya. Now, I will say for certain things like Dynamics, for simulation and for natural effects and simulation effects, I have moved beyond Maya to programs like RealFlow for liquid simulations, as well as Houdini for pyroclastic and other kind of rigid body simulations, things like that. So maybe I'll do a video on simulations inside of Houdini, because Houdini is a godsend for simulations. But so is Cinema 4D. Cinema 4D has some really good simulation stuff in it. And even Blender. Poor Maya. Well, anyway, one thing that I do really still enjoy about Maya is the fluid effects. So what I want to do is we're going to do a tornado. So we're going to do a tornado cloud that will be using particles and fluid effects. So to get started, we're going to start with a NURB curve. So if you've never used NURBS inside of Maya before, the CV curve tool, or the NURB curve tool, is right here under Create and CV curve tool. And I'm just going to draw out my curve. So something like that. There we go. Yeah. Now, I'll tell you, sometimes I've gotten errors with doing some of the NURB stuff. Usually it's an issue with Maya. And what I do to fix that is actually just delete the Maya folder in your My Documents folder. So if we look, and if we go into My Documents, there's a Maya folder right here in My Documents. So this is My Documents folder. There's a Maya folder. Delete that. If Maya's already open, make sure you close Maya first. Delete that. That'll delete all the preferences for Maya. And then when you open Maya back up, it'll remake the folder for you automatically and have a new set of preferences. And usually that fixes things. So when Maya's glitching out, sometimes the scripts get bad, or you know, you've overwritten a script, or just something weird's happened. So it's, you can clear them out by just deleting that folder. So anyway, I've drawn my curve. I'm gonna go in here and make some adjustments. So I'm gonna right click on this and go to Control Vertex Mode. And CVs are just kind of like vertexes for polygonal objects. So I'm just gonna move these around a little bit. Kind of clean this up. So it's a little bit smoother. I'm gonna go in here and say Object Mode. So it's a little bit smoother now. To really smooth this out, I'm gonna come here and go Edit Curve, and I'm just gonna go in here and say Rebuild Curve. And you'll see it really smoothed it out for me. Looks good. Next thing I wanna do, I wanna make sure my pivot point is sitting at the center of my curve that I made. And I wanna make sure it's sitting off to the right-hand side right here where this is currently at. If it's somewhere else, you can always hit Insert and then move this wherever you want it to be, and then hit Insert again and you've moved your pivot point. So this is why I want the pivot point right here. I'm going to go here to Surface, and let's go to the option box for Revolve. I want to revolve around the y-axis on an object. I want to go 0 to 360, so it makes a complete revolution, and it's going to have 8 segments. It's going to complete it, and it'll be NURBS when it comes out. So I'm going to hit Apply, and there is my shape. So I get this shape. Shape looks pretty good. I want to do two things to this shape. Actually, I'm going to do one thing to it. I want to reverse the surface. Well, not rebuild it. I want to actually reverse the surface, and that lets it show up the right way with the shaded view on the outside. Basically, it's like flipping the normals by reversing the surface direction. So now I want to add some particles to this. So I'm going to come in here and go to in dynamics. Now you can use regular particles or in particles. It does not matter which one you use. The process will be exactly the same. So for this, I'm going to give myself some more frames on the timeline first. It's like 3000. So I'm going to come in here and go in particles. I'm going to go to the create particles menu. So in particles, create in particle. And before I choose create emitter, I want to choose balls and then go back in here and say in particle, create in particle, and choose create emitter. So now when I hit playback, you'll see, oh, I got these like sparkly, these colorful spheres that are falling out of this. So I want to select, I'm going to open up my outliner. I want to select my particle and select my surface. So I select my particle, hold control and click my surface. And I'm going to come back in here to in particle and say goal. I want to rewind this and then play this back. So you'll see right now, this is generating particles and they're kind of springy and bouncing around and kind of flipping out. So I want to come in here and select those particles, go to my in particle shape. First thing I want to turn off is collisions. So I'm going to go to collisions, turn off the collision, self-colliding. Really, it's the self-collide that's giving us issue. So if I turn on self-collide and then rewind this and play it back, you'll see they're bouncing around. If I turn off the self-collide, you'll see they'll settle back down and there they go. Like they're just kind of moving through each other. So I don't want them colliding with each other. So they're not going to collide. And then the next thing I want to do is come down here to goals and weights. And my goal is good. I want this at 0.5, but I want this at 0. And so now they're just generating on there and not moving. Now you'll notice they're generating everywhere, every place where I have a CV is where these are generating at. So if I look at my control vertices, you can see they're generating where the CVs are at inside of my object, which is fine. So I'm going to select my particles again. And I want to go here to where it says per particle array attributes. And I want to open up the add dynamic attributes. So when you first, if you're using the in dynamics, if you're using the in particles, then the radius PP, opacity PP, and RGB PP will already have ramps assigned to them. That only does that if you're using the in particle particles. If you're using regular Maya particles, it doesn't do anything. But if you're using the in particle ones, it'll actually set up a per pixel for radius, opacity, and the RGB color of them. So what I want to do at this point is I'm going to come here and I want to click on right underneath add dynamic attributes, I'm going to say general and then click on my particle tab. And I'm going to go in here to goal U and V. So goal U, goal V, and let's add goal U and goal V. And I can close this now. So now here in my per particle array, I want to click on right beside goal V, there's a box right here. So I'm going to right click on this and say create expression. So the expressions are a way to talk to parts of your Maya code. So Maya is built off of a programming language that is only Maya's, which is Maya extension language, which is MIL. So if you ever hear anything talking about MIL scripts or MIL this or MIL command or whatever, that's what Maya is written off of. Now you can actually extensively change Maya based off of knowing the MIL commands and writing scripts for MIL. You can actually make pop-up windows, you can make tools in MIL and have them work for you. So we're gonna be using a little bit of MIL with this particular tutorial. So the MIL that I wanna use, this is the object. I'm talking to the in particle shape one, and then the attribute is this goal V. So you see it says dot goal V. So it's got in particle shape one dot goal V. Now this syntax structure has to be correct. You cannot have a lowercase p, it won't understand what you're talking about. You can't have a lowercase v, it won't understand what attribute you're talking to. So it has to be exactly the way that it is. So this is really nice because when you click on the object and then the attribute you want, Maya will give you the concatenation of those two. So it'll give you how this concatenates and the proper dot syntax to be able to talk to this. So I've got this in particle and I'm gonna say that it equals rand, and rand is just random. And I'm gonna say open parentheses 0, 1, and then close parentheses. and let's say create. So I'm going to close this now, rewind my playback, and then play this back. So you can see something did change, because our particles are no longer on every CV like they were before. Now they're just showing up on this like quarter part, this like probably like a quarter circle, almost a quarter circle of our overall shape. Now, this is not right. This is still not right. What's happening is that on our rand, when we did that rand 0, 1, when we did that, we were trying to talk to the 0 to 1 space of this object. Now, NURBS objects are very interesting in the fact that they do not have UVs. NURB objects are already UV surfaces, in a way. So what I mean by that is that this surface, there is a texture coordinate as well as a parameter coordinate of 0 to 1 on this, but this guy doesn't know what it 0 to 1 is right now. If I click on this NURB object, you'll see the min and maximum range. So the min and max range of, if I look in here in my surface history, I'll see min max range U is 0 to 1, but my min max range for V is 0 to 8. So it doesn't understand 0 to 1. So we're going to make it understand 0 to 1. So I'm going to click on that object, go back to my surfaces menu, and then go to edit NURBS. And I'm going to come in here to rebuild surface and show you what's going on in here. So I'm going to keep it uniform, and I'm going to say parameter range. I want to parameterize it to be 0 to 1, and I'm going to do on directions U and V. So it'll be 0 to 1 on U and V. And then keep spans. I'm actually going to do, just to make it a little bit rounder, I'm going to do 8 spans on each. Now you could do 4. 4 is still fine. But I'm going to do 8 just so it keeps a little bit more rounder shape to it. So I'm going to say apply. Boop. And you'll see now my minimum range is 0 to 1. Maximum, min max on U is 0 to 1. Min max on V is 0 to 1. So I'm going to close this. So now if I hit play, you'll see that these are actually randomly generating. So it's randomly generating 0 to 1 space around the base of this. So if I go to my particles, I can come in here and click on my particles. If I go to my particles and look at my expression, I can see that I've got in particle shape 1.goal v equals random, and I have a small array. So this is kind of my x and my y value of 0 to 1. I could have did 1 to 0, and it would still kind of be the same result. So I can close this. So the next thing I need to do is actually come in here for goal U. I need to give the goal U something so it knows how to move. Because right now it's generating around this, but it doesn't have any movement. Because I'm going to have two particle systems. One is going to come from the ground up, and one's going to come from the sky down. And that's going to make kind of my two fields for my tornado. So I'm going to come here to goal U and right click on that. And I'm not going to do create an expression. I'm actually going to say create a ramp. So I'm going to create a ramp. Rewind this and play it back. And you'll see everything now is generating from the top of this and rushing down this thing. So it's generating every at the top and rushing down. So I'm going to come back here to where it says array mapper. And I'm going to right click, go to array mapper, and I'm going to say, first of all, I'm going to say edit array mapper. So in my array mapper, you'll notice something else. The minimum value is 0, the maximum value is 1. I'm going to set the minimum value for 0 and the maximum value for 0.5, and then play this back. So you'll see now that the minimum value is 0 and the maximum value is 0.5. Now, there's still something weird going on. This is still not going up. I want it going from the ground up to the midpoint, not from the midpoint down to the ground. So I need to reverse this. So what's cool about this is, if I look, I got my array mapper, but I also have a ramp 1. I'm going to click on ramp 1, and I'm going to get rid of this middle color. So I'm going to get rid of this, and I'm just going to reverse these values. So this is going to be 0, and then this is going to be... So, if we look once again, if I click on black, you'll see the selected position is 0, and then this selected position is 1. So, look at what's happening.